said, a beautiful thing. You know what I'm saying? Having, you know, options is the beauty now of dealing with cannabis. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, like I said, for years being in Texas, like all we had was dirt weed. You know what I'm saying? And you could get some dirt weed, and then sometimes you get a bag with a bunch of stems and seeds, and you really ain't got no choice in the matter. Right, you know what I'm saying? So it's beautiful, man. And I remember the first time we went to Amsterdam. I had a show in Amsterdam and went to the cafe.
Right.
And, you know, we would buy a tree and we would sit down and smoke. And they used to really trip out there. We wouldn't mix it. You know what I'm saying? With how the Europeans tend to mix with tobacco.
Yeah, yeah. Spliffs.
Right. And I'm like, man, I can't do that shit because, like, I didn't quit cigarettes. I ain't come this far to putting that shit back in my body. And they're like, yeah, but you smoking in a blunt. You still taking in the tobacco. And it didn't really hit me for years that I was like, you know what? They kind of right. Like, I'm still putting tobacco in there. But at that point, I feel like a lot of, you know, it becomes a routine, right? And that'd be a part of your whole daily routine is you wake up and you roll up. You know, you wake up, you roll up, and you smoke. Now, I got homies that used to always tell me, like, yo, you should really, you know, try to use a bowl. You should, you know, try to dab a little bit or whatever. But I'd be having too much shit to do the dab. Like, you know, my homie down here, he's the dab master. And I'm like, dog, I don't even know. See, yeah. I'm like, I don't even know how niggas get shit done. Like, I own a piece of G-Pen. Like, I'm one of the, you know, part owners of G-Pen with my boy Chris. And I don't know how motherfuckers function.
Nah, it's tough. I always say this is the medicinal way. That's heavy medicinal with the dabbing. Unless you just like to get just fucked up. You know what I'm saying? So it's one of the, you know what I'm saying?
I love the medicinal aspect now. Even like topical, like even my mother-in-law, like CBD is legal here in Texas now, right? And so I remember a couple of months ago, my mother-in-law called us and she was like, I need to get some of that weed lotion. And we was like, what you mean weed lotion? And cause I'm like, because there is like THC. If you go to, you know, Denver, LA, you can get like lotion that, you know, has THC in it, but it's more about the CBD, right? That's where the real medicinal qualities come in with topical and shit like that, right? And I'm like, well, you know, mom, it ain't weed, you know, like you think it, like you're not gonna put some lotion on your arms and get high, you know what I'm saying? But it's about the chemical reaction that's dealing more in nerves and pain relief and stuff like that. She was like, yeah, one of my friends take that weed lotion and it helped her with her knees and I want to try it. And so now it'd be funny that my mother-in-law is calling me to make like a weed lotion run every now and then, you know? but that's a big thing in Texas, man. Like Texas has been trying to legalize for a while. And the biggest group of people that's really trying to legalize is veterans, right? You know what I'm saying? Trying to deal with PTSD. You know what I'm saying? But you know, Texas is on the Bible Belt. And, you know, a lot of people here, they just, you know, weed is bad. Drugs are bad. Right. And they don't draw a distinction between, you know, weed and cocaine and heroin. It's all drugs and it's all bad, you know. And we got people that fought and killed, you know, for this country. And they have shit that, you know, stress and memories and a lot of, you know, shit that they can't deal with. And they can't really function properly like they want to function in society without it. And so that's like the biggest, that's who basically got CBD passed in this country was the veterans. I mean, in this state, let me say, are the veterans, you know what I'm saying? Because I would go to the state capitol with the Grammy Association. I'm part of like this advocacy group for the Texas chapter of the Grammys. And I would go to petition for music rights and, you know, getting musicians properly compensated or whatever. And every time I would go, like, that's the biggest lobbying group by far. You know what I'm saying? You would see 9, 10 different groups of people going around the various state reps, you know, trying to implore them about the benefits of CBD in terms of helping veterans. And it's hard for the government to say no to veterans, right? Because they're always pushing about, you know, America first and, you know, America takes care of its own and we should respect the troops and all of that. But then the troops come home traumatized by the shit they done seen and the shit they done done. And you don't give them what they feel really, because people that know, and you're an athlete, you know, if there's a choice between weed or pills, right? People, you know, athletes would really prefer the weed.
Right.
Because because every time, because the pills, that's a different situation, right? And the pills tend to complicate the body. Like, if you take too much of this pill, it'll fuck up your liver. If you take too much of this pill, you know, it'll fuck up your kidneys. And especially when it comes to pain relief, right? If you abuse pain relief drugs, then something bad happens to you. They can't give you nothing in the hospital. You just down bad, you know? So, you know, it's been a real interesting time in Texas. And everybody believes that, you know, eventually every state will legalize. But I guarantee you, Texas will be like in the last five states.
You think?
Yeah, absolutely. Even if, you know, we talk about federal mandates too. Like, even if the federal government chose to, because in certain states, even when it is legal, like, the federal government may have issues. You would understand this as a owner with banking, right? Like, banking use tends to be like that first problem. Like, you know, a lot of bank, you know, that was the first hurdle people ask. Well, yeah, you can legalize in the state, but we don't know where you're going to keep that money, where you're going to put that money. And then as you try to open and get different accounts in different states, every state has its own process.
Yeah.
Right. That you got to adapt to, you know what I'm saying? So, it's an interesting time in this country, man. But at least
you know a lot about the industry.
Yeah, no, like I said, you know, I'm part owner in GPen. I got equity in this company called Mez. You know what I'm saying? So I've been around it for a while.
Yeah, that's dope. Stack on here talking hella shit. Steve Jack.
That's why he said he ain't never moved. Bad. I don't blame him though. You know what I'm saying? If my grandkids wasn't here, and I probably would consider move. Like, my wife wanted to move to Canada a while back. She's like, yo, I'm tired of this president. I'm tired of this country. And the only reason we really didn't move, because I got good friends in Canada, Redicon, my friend, the Montour family. They're like the number one cannabis. They've been in tobacco for years, right? So they're heavily divested in tobacco. So the infrastructure was already there. They were basically just waiting for Canada to go legal. And then once Canada went legal, they used their R&D department. You know, R&D was already working on it. So they were able to implement on a big level quickly. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
And so there was a lot of opportunities. When we moved to Canada, like, I could be doing shit. I wouldn't even have to really rap anymore. Like, I could jump dead into the brand with them. And, you know, Canada has a really good quality of life. But, you know, I wouldn't want to be that far from my grandchildren. Like, I could jump in my car right now and be next to any of my grandkids in 15 minutes. You know what I'm saying? And that's a blessing. I wouldn't want to change that at all. But man, like other places are looking, they're looking at tax revenue. You know what I'm saying? They're looking at, you know, the drop in crime. You know what I'm saying? And Texas ain't trying to hear none of that.
It'll come around eventually. It's all good, bro. So let me jump into the music real quick. So you been working on anything?
Yeah, so I've actually working on a couple of different projects when this shit happened, and that's the other thing. Like, as soon as this is over, I gotta put a setup in the office. Like, I'm in my office right now trying to figure out like where I'm gonna put my studio equipment in here, because I gotta get a studio in this motherfucker. Because I was working on an album. Me and Manny Fresh was working on an album together. Me and Zaytoven working on an album together. I started on a project with Cool and Dre, and me and Playing Skills are talking about doing some music, and even with my boy Big E Beats in Dallas. So it's a couple of different projects that I'm working on, and it's a lot easier for me to just lock in with a particular producer or a production team, so I can do everything at one point, as opposed to going around and getting beats from different motherfuckers and trying to create a sound and a vibe in that way. I learned that when my last full album, Return of the Trill, I did that exclusively with me and Big Crit. So Crit did most of the production, and then when he didn't produce a beat, he kind of picked the people who he knew had a sound that would be similar to the sound we was trying to create. And I could be putting out music like right now, but I ain't got no setup in this motherfucker. Right. You know what I'm saying? And not even a big setup. Like, somebody just gave me some advice. Shout out to Static Selector. We did an album. What you say, Al?
You said you was ready for everything. You wasn't ready? You had a studio ready?
No, man. That's the thing. I was ready for, you know, everyday life. I wasn't ready for that. And that's the only thing I feel kind of fucked up about, right? I could have been, like, fully productive, right? I was more worried about being protected But I could have still been like productive in here. But Static Selecta, who I just did an album with him last year as well, called Trill Static. He was like, "Yo, all you need is this, this, and this, and you can get it from Amazon, right? For X amount of dollars, Amazon will send you something. It's easy to set up and hook it up to your laptop, and you could be going right there." So I'm thinking at some point in the next week or two, I'm probably gonna have to make that little investment just for a small setup. Right, where I can, you know, kind of finish some of the vocals for the projects that I'm already doing, but right. then like at some point put together like a fuller setup, you know what I'm saying? That go my boy Dave say he gonna come to Houston and set my studio up. Dave is an amazing producer too, and who I'm probably gonna end up working with some music as well. But yeah, so that's the only thing, man, that I could have been doing is